Okay, so today I'm doing a little two-for-one deal on my own truck. Not a job for somebody, but yeah, I got to wire up the third brake light, and I had to buy a special little $15 module, which is basically like a diode that I got to wire up over there, and I got to run a wire to this light, and then I already ran the wire up to that light, so I got to do that. But also, what I'm doing today, because I had to take. I guess I didn't have to, but like to get the wire up in there and get it all zip tied up nice, because I don't want it hanging down and getting like caught on anything. I had to take the spare down, so I figured while I got that down, I might as well clean up underneath, and I'm going to spray some of this wool wax black undercoating. I got black, they have clear and they have black. The clear is like a yellowish clear. The black I think looks a lot better underneath. If you do like inside a tailgate or inside your door panels, you probably don't want to use black unless you have black paint. Even then, I would still probably use the clear, because some of it's going to ooze out over time and it's going to make a mess. Ain't going to look too good. So yeah, what I did, just to give you an idea, what I'll do here, actually, I'm going to move stuff around a little bit when I do it, but if you saw my vid like a month ago, I painted the exhaust, but I still really don't want to get any on there anyway, because it heats up, and better that I don't get any like wax or oil or anything up there. This is like a wax, like a wax that stays soft. So what I'm doing is I took the spare down, and I thought I was going to need, I brought a flat blade screwdriver out too, but I just used a putty knife, just that's probably like a 1 1/4 inch putty knife, around that size. Really doesn't matter, as long as you can get where you need to get. And I'm just going wherever the loose stuff is. A lot of this is still solid. If it's solid, I wouldn't touch it, but if you see bubbles like that, there's rust underneath. And I mean, it ain't gotta be perfect, but obviously the better of a job you can do, the better it's gonna hold up. And yeah, I kept up pretty good with this over the years. This truck is a 2007, and it's been in Connecticut winters since 2007. So, yeah, I always tried to, like, at least every couple years go underneath and just scrape away the loose stuff and coat it with something. About 2 years ago, I had it sprayed with tar. Basically, it's roofing tar that they heat up and spray with a gun. And it's good for sound deadening, and it's good if you have a brand new vehicle to do it, like, once. But as soon as you get rust, the rust likes to grow underneath it, so it's kind of not the greatest, but if you don't keep putting it on and you take the loose stuff in the rusted areas, you clean it off and you spray something like this. I don't have it the right way. You spray something like that on there, or fluid film, or like an oil, you're probably gonna be fine. It'll keep this kind of protected and moist, and you know, where it's like loose, you're putting different stuff over anyway. So this stuff, the problem is it's kind of hard. The good thing is it holds up for a really long time, where there's like no rust. Like here, there probably was no rust, but my tire was hitting there. But yeah, if there's rust, it just holds moisture and everything else underneath. If you live in an area that I don't know the name of the chemical, but it's basically like salt, but worse. They put that stuff on the road in the winter and it just rots everything. So you kind of got to do something, but based on reviews and what I've seen, I bought a can of this a while ago, and this stuff seems really good. It seems basically like that other one there that I just mentioned, fluid film, but it doesn't smell. Fluid film kind of smells like, ladies' makeup, to be honest. Kind of smells like lipstick. Like really pungent though. And yeah, I'd rather use this just because of the smell, and I don't know, it seems like a good product. So yeah, get like, I mean, depending on the size of your vehicle and how bad it is underneath, if you get like I think it was a 6-pack case of these, and that seemed like about the best deal I could find. I believe I got them on eBay, but it may have been somewhere else on the internet. And yeah, I'll just, like right here, I'll demonstrate. Just enough to coat, especially areas like that that are kind of hidden away that aren't going to get much weather exposure or stuff getting flung up from the tires, so I'm not too concerned about it. Let's try over here. I hope my camera, I don't know how it works when I'm recording, like does it try to like flip around and shit? I don't know, but yeah. So like over here, you know. And I should get up inside here too, because outside, that's one thing, you get that. But like, because this is hollow, you know, up inside there. I have a wand, I'll have to put it on. I don't think I'm gonna demonstrate that, but yeah, basically, like you would just try to fish it up this way, spray as you're pulling it out, and then fish it up that way, and then spray as you're pulling it out. And you coat the inside. And yeah, so there's one of the wires, that red wire right there. I brought that up over to that side, and then it runs over to that side, and then the other one goes up to my battery, and that's for the cargo light. I'll show you real quick so you know what I mean. I have in the back of my cap here, which has been a pain, but it's coming along, I got a cargo light. So yeah, I needed consistent, I mean, I didn't need it. I could have, some people wire them to like the headlight switch. Or the, not for the headlights, but I mean for like your parking lights. I didn't want to do that. I wanted to have it so I could turn it on at any time and not have the key in the ignition, because honestly, I probably won't even use it that much, but when I do, it'll probably be like, okay, you know, I park my truck, I get out, I take the key out, and then I come back here and I want to turn the light on so I can see back here. So that was my reasoning on that. You just got to remember not to shut it. You got to remember to shut it off when you're done. Otherwise, you're going to kill your battery. It's not like on cars for a long time now, probably since like the 90s. If you left your like dome light inside the cab on, it would, maybe not all of them, but I know this one and a lot of vehicles, it'll shut off after like 3 minutes or 5 minutes. So, but like way back when, yeah, if you left it on, it would drain your battery. So that's where I came out with the wires. A lot of people will come out, maybe there's a hole right here, maybe here, or underneath here, there's another hole, but I put caps over those. I really don't want to come out over here, because if I take the cap off, then I'm gonna have wires hanging here. So what I figured was put the wires here and just put it up underneath there. I got a bunch of weather stripping underneath there anyway, so it's not like it's sitting on the wire, this fiberglass part. It's not like a hard piece from the cap is sitting on there, so it shouldn't wear through the insulation. And there's a square opening in here, so if I ever take the cap off, I just unplug this, I send this down through the square opening, and maybe tie it up with something.